Dance Theatre of Harlem was incorporated on February 11th, 1969, which is 51 years ago, but we're celebrating our 50th anniversary over 2 years because we're so excited about it. It's almost unbelievable that we are 50 years old, but that's true. So we're here in Youngstown as part of our 50th anniversary tour, in which we've gone to cities across the country, really keeping Arthur Mitchell's vision of what the company is about alive, and really trying to bring more people close to this art form. Arthur Mitchell was an important ballet dancer with the New York City Ballet, and he was actually the first African American to be part of an American ballet company. So when he created Dance Theatre of Harlem, he really wanted to show the world what ballet might be if it was inclusive. Then, in the 1960s and the 1950s and the 1940s, people thought that black people couldn't do ballet, that we didn't belong in this art form, mm-hmm. that we didn't have the temperament, that we didn't have the talent, that we couldn't understand it, that we didn't have the bodies. There were all these preconceived notions about who belonged in ballet and who didn't. Mm-hmm. But Arthur Mitchell was a very successful dancer. And so he wanted to create the opportunity for people to see that ballet was really a matter of access and opportunity. Mm-hmm. That if you gave people, anyone, not just African Americans, the chance to really develop as an artist, to go through the long, rigorous training, and if you had the talent, that you could be successful. But the most important thing about that, though, was that he felt that ballet was so much more than what people were thinking. Mm-hmm. Yes, it was started in the court of Louis XIV. It's a Western European art form. But ballet is really about elevation of the spirit. It's about lifting yourself up in a world that often is very depressing. And so that belongs to everyone. It doesn't belong to one culture or one group of people. And ballet is a way of taking people out of their ordinary lives and letting them know that, yes, there is something more to life. So that's what Dance Theatre of Harlem really was about. Mm-hmm. People tend to think of it as a black ballet company. Mm-hmm. He never intended this to be a resegregation. You have your white companies and your black companies and they're doing ballet. No, it's about ballet as an art form encompassing what it is to be a human being. We're doing a lecture demonstration for young people on Wednesday morning, and we're also giving a full performance at the Deyor Theater Wednesday evening. And that program has four ballets that are very typical to Dance Theatre of Harlem. One of my goals as artistic director is to show that ballet can say many different things. Mm-hmm. It's a language that can say many different things. The first work on the program is a work called Orange. It was choreographed by Stanton Welch. The music is Vivaldi, and it's the most classical of the works. It is full of symmetry, it's full of patterns, it's full of long, extended lines. This is what people often think of ballet. You think about the formality of ballet. Mm-hmm. Orange is actually a pretty joyous work, but it has a certain formality to it. The second work on the program follows what Dance Theatre of Harlem does in a particular way, in that it uses the language of ballet. The same steps that you'll see in Orange are now done in a duet that's to a song sung by Dinah Washington. Mm-hmm. And so it's a very contemporary evocation of what ballet can say. The third work on the program is an important work called Passage. It was commissioned by the 1619 commemoration to make note of the arrival of the first Africans on American soil in 1619 in Hampton Bays, Virginia. It was choreographed by a young African-American choreographer, Claudia Schreier, and the music is a commissioned score by young African-American female composer, Jessie Montgomery. So in this, both of these young artists have tried to depict in an abstract way the journey of that first step onto American soil, a journey full of terror and hope. Mm-hmm. It's very significant that we have a work that's both choreographed and composed by females and African-American females. Ballet is that traditional art form that has been so long the province of men. So now we're trying to inject new voices into the art form. The last work on the program is really quintessential Dance Theatre of Harlem. The music is Aretha Franklin and James Brown. Mm-hmm. But once again, you're using that ballet vocabulary, using it in a very different way, using it in a way that says, ballet, it's for everyone.
I got the feeling, baby.
My very best friend is Stephanie Dabney. She grew up in Youngstown, and she auditioned for Dance Theatre of Harlem in 1975 when the company came to the Powers Theatre. And Arthur Mitchell saw her talent right away, and he wanted to take her right away into the company. And her mother said, oh no, she's too young. So she finished out her high school, and she came to Dance Theatre of Harlem and became one of our major principals dancers. She was, of course, the firebird for many years. That ballet was created on her. And she is a great, great friend and a great, great woman.
And I love you.
When you hear the word ballet and you say, it's not for me, you have to give it a chance. Dance Theatre of Harlem is really showing what ballet can be, and it's something that engages people in a way that people think that ballet is not necessarily going to be. You think that, is it going to be, am I going to know whether it's good or bad? It's an experience. When you come into the theater and you see Dance Theatre of Harlem and you share this experience with a group of people who are coming to see this one moment in time, it's never going to be repeated. You can't watch it again on video. This moment in time when you're sharing something with the artist on the stage, it's a life-changing experience. I got soul. I'm super bad.